Interior designer and part-time model Stanley John moved down from Oxford last June, hoping to find more work here. Together with his girlfriend Doreen and his son Delbert, he squatted in this empty flat in Camberwell. But he then spent, he claims, around £7,000 of his savings and earnings refurbishing the flat. In July, he went to Lambeth Council and volunteered to pay them rent so that he could, in his eyes, legalise his position. But the council responded by sending in the bailiffs this morning.
Well, I'm not going to...
You're not going? No. I think the housing people seem to think that you are.
They failed to get him out, but Lambeth Council said the bailiffs would return.
Mr John is a squatter. He came to London from Oxford. He has no claim on Lambeth Council to house him at all. He has taken a property ahead of people who are waiting their turn in the council queue, including 460 families in bed and breakfast. He has been given notice to quit, and he has no right to remain in the property. The council will secure possession of that property. We will do it in accordance with the law, using the court bailiffs and the police.
But now that we've gone, will you do that today?
We will do it at a convenient time to the police and the bailiffs.
When we're not there?
When you're not there. Mr. John knew he had no entitlement to that flat, and if he went ahead and spent money on it, he was doing so very foolishly and unwisely, in the knowledge that he had no claim to be there.
So as far as you're concerned, when you get rid of him, that's just tough luck on him and he's lost his money?
Yes.
But because the flat he's in had been empty for months, Stanley John still feels the council should let him stay.
The fact remains that you are a squatter, you had the money to rent a place properly, why didn't you?
We didn't class ourselves because of squatter. We didn't class ourselves as a squatter. We saw about the premises, and came in to look at the premises, and we decided to do it up and then go to the council about it and ask them if it's possible to start paying rent for the premises.
But if you had the money to rent a flat legally in the first place, why didn't you do that?
Well, we didn't, it's very hard to explain, actually. We were quite desperate, and we did try a lot of agencies, and all the agencies were on book. They said that there's no way they can help us until further down the year. I mean, further down the year would be too late, really.
And this evening, Stanley John is still awaiting the next inevitable knock on the door from the bailiffs. Christopher Rainbow for Thames News.